So today we shall take up another theoretical topic, classification of covering projections. Like classification of spaces, now we are classifying the functions, which are all covering projections. Obviously, what we are going to do is we are going to fix the base space. Base space is fixed up to homeomorphism. So the covering projections will be classified up to homeomorphism, which take one projection to another projection. Okay, it is not just the classification of the top spaces up to homeomorphism. The homeomorphism should preserve the covering projection. So this leads to what are known as covering transformations and so on. So we shall go on introducing some of these. And finally, we'll see that they again use group theory. Namely, they are closely related to subgroups of pi 1 of x. Okay. So let us go through this topic. So here is a definition. Take two covering projections, P1 and P2, over X. We say they are equivalent if there is a homeomorphism from X1 bar to X2 bar, such that when you compose it with P2, it gives you P1. So the projection map P1 is taken to P2 by F. So that is the meaning of this one. Okay. Is the definition clear? Now, this is easily seen that it is an equivalence relation, first of all. If there is a map like this, you take F inverse, that will give you F P1 composite F inverse will be equal to P2. So this means that the P1 is equivalent to P2 implies P2 equivalent to P1. Every P1 is equivalent to itself, no problem. Again, if there is a P3 and a homeomorphism G from X2 to X3, such that P3 composite G equal to P2, then you take G composite F of P3, that will be equal to P1. So that will show that G composite F is a covering projection, is an equivalence between X1 and P1 and P3. So this is a transitive relation. So equivalence under this one is actually equivalent, equal, you are calling it equivalent, so it's the equivalence relation. So it's justified. Okay. So equivalence classes of covering projections is what we want to study. Given a covering projection P from Y to X cross I, remember there is an exercise given to you earlier. Restricted to X cross T, you get various covering projections. And the exercise was that these are all equivalent without I define that one. Now, in terms of this definition, what you have to show that is that all these, think of X cross T as if X, it is X, forgetting T. Okay. Then under that homeomorphism, X cross single T going to X, under that homeomorphism, all these covering projections, restrictions X cross T, they are all equivalent to each other. That was the exercise. Okay. So that is an example, provided you have solved it. We will see some more things like that here. Two covering projections over X, okay, are equivalent if and only if they define the same subgroup pi 1 of x up to conjugation. Therefore, if two subgroups, corresponding subgroups are not conjugate to each other, then you will know that the covering projections are not equivalent. So this is a starting point of relating the equivalence classes of covering projections to subgroups of pi 1 of x. So let us see how this one comes. This is one straight line and a one line proof. P1 and P2 are covering projections. F from x1 to x1 bar to x2 bar is an equivalence. Let us pick up points x1 bar and x2 bar, okay, over inside xi bars over the same point pi 1 in x, say x base point, such that f1 of x2 is equal to x2. Okay, take one point here, f1, f2, and take that as x2 there. Then since f is a homeomorphism, we have f check of pi 1 of x1 bar is equal to pi 1 of x2 bar. This we have seen because f is a homeomorphism. Therefore, when you apply p1 check of pi 1 of x1 bar, little x1 bar, is equal to p2 composite f check of pi 1 of x1 bar, which is p2 check of pi 1 of x2 bar. So now suppose these two are conjugate to each other. Now this time, I don't know what point I have to take. I have taken p1 check of f1 and this is pi1 of x2 at some other point. Suppose these are conjugate to each other. Okay. For some element tau in pi1 of xx, where this x is p1 of x1 bar is equal to p2 of x2 bar. I don't know what map we have, but I have chosen x1 and x2, x1 bar and x2 bar, sitting over the same point. Then only I can talk about pi1 of xx. When I talk about this one, there are two subgroups, and I am assuming that these two subgroups are conjugate to each other. That means this one is conjugate of that one. All right. Now I will produce a map which takes x1 bar to x2 bar, and this map will be a homeomorphism such that when you compose with F composite P2 will be equal to P1. So that's what I'm going to do. Okay. So let lambda be a path in x2 bar such that at 0, I mean starting point is x2, and when you compose p2 composite lambda, it is this tau. So I have lifted tau, that loop tau, into x2 bar. Okay? That is what it is. End point of this lambda will be x2 bar. Okay? X2 hat. Some other point. Then we have lambda inverse pi 1 of x2 bar lambda. This we know, right? Lambda is a path from x1 bar, x2 bar to x2 hat. So x2 hat loops at x2 hat. Okay, looped at x2 will get converted into loops at x2 hat. So this is the isomorphism. Okay, therefore, it follows that P2 check, if you apply, of pi 1 of x2 hat on this side, it is P2 check of this thing. P2 check of lambda inverse is tau inverse. Then I have P2 check of pi 1 of x2 bar x bar. That is tau on this side. Okay, but we have assumed that this tau is nothing but P1 of x1 bar. So what I got is now, for some other point, you see, x2 hat, some other point at x2 bar, the fundamental group maps to the same group under P2 check. Okay, so equality was given in the earlier case, forward case. In the backward case, we had to get this one after starting with a conjugate. The conjugate is there when you fix your points yourself. Now, the conjugate will tell you what point you should take so that the groups become equal. That is the idea. So now, P2 check is equal to P1 check because I have changed the base point in X2. Equivalently, I could have changed the base point in X1 by reversing the arguments here. Okay, these are symmetric arguments. So now what? Now you apply the lifting criteria. You see, I have told you that we keep on applying the lifting criteria. To map F from X1 bar to X2 bar, okay, or G to get these maps, either to P1 or to P2. So you have P2 from X2 bar to X1 bar, take P1 from X1 bar to X. Take X1 bar as Y. Then you get a map from this Y to X2 bar, right? But Y is nothing but X1 bar. So you can do the other way around also. So both ways you will get maps F and G such that P2 composite F is P1 and P1 composite G is P2. But what happens? X1 bar goes to X2 hat and G of X2 hat comes back to X1 bar. So this is the starting point assumption. Whenever you are lifting, you are specifying the one point. The lift of one single point you have to specify. Okay. Now, if you take P2 composite G composite F or F composite G, okay, see P2 of F is what? P2 of F is P1. Then P1 of G is P2. Okay, so P2 F composite G will be equal to P2. So G composite F or F composite G here is the lift of P2 itself. Through P2, but identity map is also a lift. And F composite G of X2 hat will come back to X2 hat. So identity map and F composite G agree at one point. And X2 bar is connected and so on, that we have to assume, right? We have assumed connected spaces. Therefore, F composite G must be identity map by the uniqueness of the lifts. Similarly, G composite F is also identity map of X1 quadrant. So F and G are inverses of each other automatically. Okay. So that gives you that lifting problem, which we have solved, is used here to show that if the fundamental group level P1 check and P2 check give you conjugate subgroups, then the coverings are equivalent. What are the assumptions? Assumptions that they are connected coverings. So, what we have seen is equivalence classes of a connected covering space corresponds to a unique conjugacy class of subgroups of fundamental group. In fact, take a covering projection X bar to X, you have freedom to choose the base point above inside the fiber. As you keep changing the base point, the subgroups will become different, but they are all conjugate. So within a space, if you pick the space, if you change the base point, what happens is you are getting conjugate subgroups. Nothing else happens if you change the whole space but keep the group as conjugate to itself. Then it has to be a homeomorphic trait. The points get, base points may get shuffled. That's all. Okay. If you fix the base points also, one going to other, even the same conjugacy subgroup will get no other conjugate subgroup. Okay. conjugacy, number of conjugacy classes will also depend upon these number of these things up to something. Of course, several of them may give you the same conjugacy class. Okay. So to complete the picture, given any subgroup K of pi 1, we should also be able to tell whether there or not there is exist a covering. So this is not done yet. So what we have got is each conjugacy class goes to a subgroup, conjugate subgroup. Each isomorphism class goes to a conjugate subgroup. If you have a subgroup, will there be a covering which comes to that? That is the fundamental problem here, namely the ontoness of this one. Okay. If two coverings go to the same conjugacy class of a subgroup, then they are equivalent. So that is a equivalence classes going to the conjugate subgroup is an injective mapping. To complete the picture, we ask whether it is surjective. Surjective means what? Given any subgroup, can you construct a covering such that under P check, it will come to one of the conjugates? Of course, once it comes to one of the conjugates, you can actually make it a subgroup also by changing the base point. That much you know already. Okay. In particular, suppose I take the trivial group. K equal trivial group is also allowed. You have to answer this question to all the subgroups of pi 1 of x. So take trivial group. What is the corresponding question? Does there exist a covering projection for which the total space is simply connected? Remember, P check is an injective mapping. If P check of pi 1 of x bar is equal to trivial group, it follows that pi 1 of x bar itself is trivial. So given any space, do we have a covering that has that the covering is simply connected? The top space is simply connected. So this is a special question. I mean, a particular case of the question, but it turns out that the method of attacking this problem is first to solve this problem, the simplest problem. Namely, when k equal to trivial group. Once you solve this one, it will tell you how to get other groups. Okay. So that is the way it is done. I mean, in theory, in how to solve this problem, you solve the simple problem first. Our next goal is to ask this. Solve this problem. All right. So I repeat, instead of going to next thing, I repeat this one. What we want is now starting with a space, okay, which is locally path connected and path connected, let us assume. Take any point, doesn't matter, and look at the fundamental group of that space at that point. Look at subgroups. Will there be a covering projection corresponding to these subgroups? Means covering projection must have isomorphic to sub fundamental group isomorphic to the subgroup under P check. P check is already an injective mapping, right? In a monomorphism. So onto the image, it will be an isomorphism. Okay? So this is our goal. So let us make a few definitions. Starting with a covering projection, P from x bar to x, a covering transformation. What is the meaning of covering transformation? So let us understand this one. Okay? From x bar to x bar itself, there is a homeomorphism such that P composite F equal to P. So in other words, it is an equivalence of X itself with X. X itself there may be other equivalences, right? That's what it's now. Homeomorphism from X bar to X bar, such that P composite F is a P itself. P1 composite F equal to P2 defined the two being equal. So these are the equivalences of X bar with itself. Okay. So these equivalences will form a group now under composition. Because if F is an equivalence, what we are calling covering transformation. Then G is a covering transformation. Composite will be also a covering transformation. Inverse will be also a covering transformation. Therefore, under composite, this forms a group which will be denoted by GP. Okay, GP is a set of all covering transformations, forms a subgroup of all homeomorphisms, because each of them is homeomorphic, under the usual composition of maps. This group is called the Deck transformation group. It is also called the Galois group of P. The Deck transformation group of P, or the Galois group of P, it's heavily dependent upon P. It is not all homeomorphisms of X bar. Okay, so this is the definition of Deck transformation, Galois transformation. The basic lemma, again, group theoretic here, is the following. There is an injective map in phi, which is just a function theoretic, set theoretic map, of GP to the right cosets of K in pi 1 of X. Remember, the right cosets of K have played some good role here, right? Earlier also they had come. I will recall it again. The K is the image of pi 1 of X bar under PHF. Okay. So the right cosets of K, okay, you take a sub of that will be GP. GP, there is an injective mapping. Okay. Moreover, K is a normal subgroup if and only if this phi is an isomorphism. That means not only this map phi, which we are going to define, is a bijection, it will be a homomorphism. It's an isomorphism. In general, it is just a set theoretic map. Okay. Moreover, K is a normal subgroup if and only if phi is an isomorphism of groups. In any case, the cardinality of GP is always less than or equal to the number of sheets of P, which is precisely equal to F inverse of any point, or P inverse of any point, number of sheets. Why suddenly number of sheets come? Look at, we have a bijection of the right cosets with the fiber earlier. So this is nothing but the right cosets as a set is the fiber of P, number of sheets. And GP have an injective map into this one. So the cardinality of this one will be less than cardinality of the fibers. Okay. So this is the lemma. So non-trivial part is to define this mapping and what? Show that K is, show that it is injective. Then if K is normal, then this becomes surjective and the map becomes a homomorphism. All right. So this thing we will do next time, not today. All right, that is the goal. Okay, thank you.